morning students. Today we are going to study maths of class 4. Today we are going to study new chapter, chapter 5, subtraction. So all of you please open page number 29 and let's start. So students, all of you open chapter 5, subtraction, page number 29, 5.1, revision. Exercise 5A. Okay, so means your first exercise is revision. And first question is subtract the following. Okay, means you have to do subtraction, and I hope all of you are knowing how to do subtraction. Question A is 7438 minus 4849. Okay, so what we have to do, first of all we will take borrow. Okay, so 8 became 18, and 18 minus 9, 9. Now 3 will become 2, so again we will take borrow from 4, so 2 will become 12, and 12 minus 4 is 8, we'll get 8. Now 4 will become 3, and we will take borrow from 7, so 3 will become 13, 13 minus 8, 5, and 7 will become 6, so 6 minus 4, we can minus 6 from 4, and you will get 2. Okay, so students, we as you all know that we only take borrow when we need, like we can't minus smaller number from smaller number greater number, but like here we can minus 6 from 4. Okay, so here no need of taking borrow and all. Okay, so what we will get, 2589. Okay, now let's see question number B. Question B is 8207 minus 5814. Okay, so we can first of all we have to minus 7 from 4, so we'll get 3. No need of taking borrow and all, because 7 is greater than 4. Now next is 0. 0 minus 1. So we can't minus 0 from 1. Okay. So here we need to take borrow. Okay. So we will take borrow from 2. And the 0 will become 10. So students, as you can see, we have taken borrow from 2. Now 0 became 10. 10 minus 1, 9. Okay. 2 became 1. So we have taken borrow from 8. 1 became 11, 11 minus 8, 3. Now 8 became 7, 7 minus 5, 2. So answer is 2393. Clear all of you? Now let's see question C. Question C is 9048 minus 782. Okay. So first of all we'll minus 8 from 2, we'll get 6. Now 4 minus 8, so here we need borrow. Okay, here we need borrow, so we next number is 0, so we can't borrow anything from 0. So first of all we will borrow from 9. So after borrowing from 9, this 0 will become 10, then we will borrow from 10, then this will 4 become 14, and 10 will become 9, and 8 will become, sorry, 9 will become 8. Okay, so as you can see, we have taken, first of all we have taken borrow from 9. Okay, so the 0 will become 10. Now we will take borrow from 10, 4 will become 14, 10 will become 9, and here 9 will become 8. And after subtracting, we will get 8266. Okay, 8266. Okay, now let's see question D. Question D is 8007 minus 2184. Okay, so here no borrowing is needed. Simply we can minus 7 from 4, we will get 3. Now here 0 is there. Okay, again we can't minus 0 from 8, we can't minus 0 from 1, so we have to take borrow from 8. Okay, so as you can see, we have taken borrow from 8. This 0 will become 10, then 10 will give 2, the 0, and the 0 will become 10. Because of giving borrow, the 0 will become 9, 8 will become 7. Okay, now 10 minus 8, 2, 9 minus 1, 8, and 7 minus 2, 5. Okay, and your answer is 5823. Clear all of you? I hope first question is clear. It's simple subtraction. Now let's see question number 2. Now students, let's see question number 2. Solve in your notebook. In this question, again we have to do subtraction. Let's see question A. So question A is subtract 27,247 from 32,304. Okay, so what does it mean? It means that you have to subtract 27,247 from 32,304. It means that 32,304 you will write upside. Okay, because it's bigger and it's written from. Okay, and downward we will write 27,247. Okay, and we will do the minus. Okay, now let's see 4 minus 7. So 4 minus 7, it's not possible. So what we have to do? We will take borrow. Again, next number is 0. We can't take borrow from 0. Okay. So what we have to do? In the same thing we have done in the previous one, previous questions. Yes. We will take 0, will take borrow from 3. Okay. So students, we have taken borrow from 3. Okay, 0 will become 10. Okay, now 4 will take borrow from 10. 10 became 14, and 4 became 14, and 10 will become 9, and 3 became 2. Now we can't minus 2 from 7, so we will take again 2 will take borrow from 3. Okay, so this 2 will become 12. So 12 minus 7, 5, and this 3 will become 2. So 2 minus 2, 0. So now let's see 14 minus 7, 7, 9 minus 4, 5, 2 minus 2, 0, 12 minus 7, 5, and 2 minus 2, 0. Okay, so your answer is 5057. Clear all of you? 5057. I hope you understood this question. It's again a simple subtraction. Okay, now let's see question number B. So second question is subtract 19,437 from 30,040. Okay, again it's written 19,437 from, okay, means you have to deduct 19,347 from 30,040. Okay, so 30,040 minus 19,437. Okay, again we have to take borrow from, so we can't minus 7 from 0, so we will take borrow. 0 will take borrow from 4. Okay, so students, after taking borrow from 4, 10, 0 became 10, 4, 3. Okay, so we will minus 10 from 7, 10 minus 7, 3, 0 minus, 3 minus 3, 0. Okay, now again 0 minus 4. Okay, so we have to take, again we have to take borrow. The next number again is 0. Okay, so the 0, this 0 will take borrow from 3. Okay, so after taking borrow, the 0 will become 10, and after taking borrow from 10, this 0 will again, this 0 will become 10. So 10 minus 4, 6. Now this 0 will, this 10 will become 9, 9 minus 9, 0, and this 3 will become 2, so 2 minus 1, 1. Clear all of you? So after subtraction, you will get 10,603. Okay, so your answer is 10,603. Clear all of you? Now, question number C. So students, question C is subtract 8,497 from 12,083. Okay, so we have to subtract 8,497 from 12,083. Okay, so I will write 12,083 upside and 8,497 downwards. Okay, now again the same simple subtraction. We can't minus 3 from 7, so we will take borrow from 8. Okay, this 3 will become 13. Okay, so after taking borrow from 8, 3 will become 13. Okay, so 13 minus 7, 9. Now 8 after giving borrow, 8 became 7, so it's not possible to minus 7 from 9. Okay, so again we will take borrow. Next number is 0. Okay, so 0 will take borrow from 2. Okay, so the 0 will become 10 and 8 will become 17. So 17 minus 9, 8. Okay, after giving borrow, 10 will become 9. So 9 minus 4, 5. Okay, now 2 became 1, so again it will take carry, so it will take borrow, so this 1 will become 11. So 11 minus 8, 3, and this 1 will become 0. Okay, so after subtraction you will get 3,589. Okay, so again 13 minus 7, 9, then 17 minus 9, 8, 9 minus 4, 5, 11 minus 8, 3. Okay, 3589. So students, question second from A to C we have solved, and question D and question E, these two questions are your homework. Okay, so practice for your practice. Now let's see question number C. Now students, third question is simplify. Okay, question A is 2424 minus 1783, okay, plus 7128 minus 863 minus 64. Okay, so after looking at this question, I think many of you got confused that how we have to do and all. So students, it's very easy and very simple. Okay, see, simply what we have to do, first we will solve this before plus sign, then numbers which are given, the equation is given of subtraction, means 2424 minus 1783. First we will do this, we will subtract this, then we will subtract 7128 minus 863 and minus 64 separate. Okay, see, like this. So first we will solve this. So 2424 minus 1783, what we will get? We will get 641. Okay, now we will solve all the numbers, we will subtract all the numbers given after the plus sign. Okay, so 7128 minus 863 minus 64. So first of all, we will solve, we will minus 7128 minus 863. So what we will get? We will get 6265. Now we will take this minus 64 here. Okay, now we will subtract 64 from 6265. Simply what we will get? 6201. Okay, again I am explaining, first we will solve, we will minus these two numbers. Okay, that is, we will subtract 863 from 7128, we will get 6265. Then we will minus 6265 minus 64, and we will get 6201. Now what we have to do? Now we have solved all the both the equations before plus sign and after the plus sign. Okay, so before the plus sign, after doing the subtraction of these two numbers, we got 641, and after doing the subtraction of these three numbers, we got 6201. Now we have, what we have to do, we will add both the numbers, both the answers. Why? Because this plus sign is given. Okay, so the answer we got from subtracting these two numbers, we will write here. The answer we got after subtracting these three numbers, we will write here. That is 6201 plus 641. Okay, and what we will get? We will get 6842. Clear all of you? I think solution is clear. Now students, let's see question number B. So question number B is 17,040 minus 11,017 plus 18,948 minus 20,374 plus 11,440. Okay, so this question is little bit different from question A, because in this question negative numbers and positive numbers are written in mixed form. Okay, so what will be the first step? First we will write positive numbers together and negative numbers together. Okay, then we will add all the positive numbers and write one side, then we will add all the negative numbers and we will write another side, and we will put minus sign in between, and then we will minus, do the subtraction. Okay, see, like this. First positive number 17,040 we will write here, then plus another positive number is 8,948 we will write, then plus another positive number is 11,440. Okay, I hope you know positive numbers and negative numbers, means numbers which are having plus sign are negative, positive, and numbers which are having minus sign are negative numbers. Okay, now minus 11,714 and next negative number is 20,374. Okay, now what will be the next step? We will add all the positive numbers together. Okay, so after adding all the positive numbers, that is 17,040 plus 8,948 plus 11,440, we will get 37,428. Okay, we will put minus. Now next step is we will add the given negative numbers. We will add, again I am saying, we will add the negative numbers, that is 11,714 minus 20,374. Okay, after adding positive numbers we got 37,428. Okay, minus, after adding all the negative numbers we got 32,088. Now we will minus 37,428 and we will do the subtraction. 37,428 minus 32,088 and we will get 5,340. Okay students, I hope this solution is clear. It's very simple. Again I am repeating, you will write all the positive numbers all together, we will write all the negative numbers all together, then we will add all the positive numbers, and afterwards we will add all the negative numbers, and afterwards we will do the subtraction and you will get your answer. Okay, now students, question A and B I have given, and last question, that is question C, it's your homework. Okay, so your exercise 5A is, your exercise 5A is completed. So students, your exercise 5A is completed. All of you, please do all the sums in your notes and do your homework, and in the next video we will study properties of subtraction. Okay, thank you.